Hello and good morning, everyone, and welcome to today's live Zoo to You. My name is Katie. I'm an educator here at Stone Zoo. Today, extraordinaire Bridget. Excited to be talking all about our snow leopards here at Stone Zoo. Today, by MIFA on behalf of the UFund College Investing Plan. And you can learn more about the plan by following the link in our caption. So our zookeeper, Bridget, talking all about our snow leopards, Kira and Himal, today. And we're going to watch them go out onto exhibit. So Bridget is going to be shifting them onto exhibit. We'll see if we can get a nice cool look of them coming out for the day and enjoying all of their new enrichment that they have in their nice and tidy home. So if you have any questions about our snow leopards, please ask away in the comment section and we will do our very best to answer them during the course of our video today. Snow leopards are a COVID-sensitive species, which is why zookeeper Bridget is wearing a mask while she is within 6 feet of distance and shifting them onto their habitat, just to make sure that Kira and Himal are nice and safe. All right, so Bridget, we have an exciting video today. Can you tell us why this week is so special?
So Kira and Himal actually just both celebrated a birthday. Himal's birthday was on May 7th and Kira's was on May 15th. They both just turned 14 years old. They're getting a little bit of enrichment right now. They're both enjoying separately a big pile of straw that was in with our agoutis here at the park. A lot of the predators here get scent enrichment. Scent is a really important form of communication and knowledge obtaining for predators. They learn a lot about their environment, about the species around them by utilizing scent. So they're both very much enjoying it. We're looking at Kira. She is having a great time. The agouti pea tends to be especially scented, so it's always a very fun form of enrichment for them.
And one of our most frequently asked questions from visitors is, how do you tell Kira and Himal apart? And I feel like you are our expert, can give us some pro tips on how to tell them apart when they're out in their habitat.
I sure can try. Snow leopards are a little bit unique in that the males and females are pretty similarly sized. Kira and Himal only have about 10 pounds of difference in between them. So they, when you look at them, they do look pretty similar. Kira has kind of a more narrow face. Himal's head looks rather large. It's hard to put an exact descriptor on it. They're both very similar in color. Their colors also kind of change throughout their shedding seasons. So if you see Kira, she's got a little bit of a more narrow, sleek face, and Himal has a much larger, rounder head.
His eyes are also kind of further apart.
People tend to say, whereas Kira looks like a very classic snow leopard.
Absolutely.
But if you catch him all, he's very, very majestic. He looks very, very handsome out here on his exhibit. So it's a little bit hard to tell. It's especially hard to tell when they're up in their favorite spot all the way on the top of the rocks. But do your best.
So there are so many reasons why we're talking to Bridget today of all of our fabulous zookeepers, but there's one reason that kind of stands out, especially because of her very recent trip. So Bridget, I was wondering if you could tell us a little bit more about Zoo New England's partnership with Snow Leopard Trust and your very exciting recent trip with Snow Leopard Trust in Mongolia.
Yeah, so we partner with the Snow Leopard Trust. They work in several different countries where the snow leopard's home ranges, such as China, Mongolia, Pakistan, Kyrgyzstan. India, all those sorts of places where there are mountain ranges for snow leopards to traverse. I recently spent some time at the end of April and beginning of May with the Snow Leopard Trust in Mongolia in the Tost Mountains. That's where they're doing a long-term ecological study on the snow leopards. They've found out through capturing a few, as well as a very extensive photo or camera trap program. Lots and lots of stuff about snow leopards, about the prey items that they tend to eat, about how they're traversing that space and how their kind of own home ranges reflect. So I met the collaring group, I met the photo camera trap group, and kind of learned more about how they do what they do, what they've learned. And I met a lot of wonderful Mongolian people that are working to conserve this amazing species. And that's one of the great things about the Snow Leopard Trust, is that it's very community oriented, and it's very important to them to include the community and make sure that they feel the ownership of this conservation.
And can you talk a little bit about what we do here at Stone Zoo to help with snow leopard research?
Yeah, sure. In the past, we have been a part of our own photo study. We have submitted photos of our cat spots to help them identify what's important about the spots and what's unique, because every spot pattern on a snow leopard is like one of our fingerprints. It's completely unique. So we've participated in studies like that. We've participated in footprint studies as well. Anything that we can do to help our wild counterparts and our research counterparts learn more about snow leopards is really cool. We have a controlled environment, and we're able to manipulate our environment here. So that's something that they don't have when they're collaring animals or trying to find them in the wild. They're tracking them with their footprints. So we can tell them a little bit more because of our controlled environment and give them some tips on what they might implement out there. And anything behaviorally that we note every day, different behaviors, we can kind of share information on a global and international level to help them.
And we talked a lot about studying snow leopards out in the wild and protecting them. Can you just talk a little bit about why that's so important, especially now, and what's going on with snow leopard populations?
Sure. It's just so snow leopard conservation, like a lot of other conservation programs, is really important because it's looking at the whole ecosystem. It's looking at the predators and the prey of the region. It's taking into account ecological factors such as droughts, rainfall, and commandeered Pira's pile. It's apparently more important than his was. So we just want to make sure that we're looking at all of the possible points of what affects populations, the populations of all of the animals and all of the life in the Gobi Desert. It's super important. It's actually where they're from is warming at a higher rate than the Northern Hemisphere, so it's very important to look at what's happening and try to figure out solutions.
And, you know, even though we are here in Massachusetts, there are a lot of things that we can do to help snow leopards just by visiting the zoo. Since we are partners with Snow Leopard Trust, when you visit the zoo, you're also supporting Snow Leopard Trust and all of the amazing work that they're doing to study and protect snow leopards out in their natural habitat, and to also empower the people that are sharing the same spaces as snow leopards. if you are visiting the zoo and you're, you know, interested in, you know, getting involved even more, if you visit our gift shop, we actually have a lot of really beautiful handcrafted items made by the women that live in Mongolia using wool from their livestock. So you're also supporting the people that share their space with snow leopards, which I think is really amazing, and a really important aspect of conservation is also, you know, supporting the local communities that those animals are found in. So to kind of finish up before we see if there's any questions, Bridget, I was wondering if you could tell us what your favorite things are about Kira and Himal.
Sure. Definitely their personalities. Kira is quite the diva. She definitely runs the exhibit. She's very much in charge. But Himal is a very sweet and subdued creature. He's a lot of fun to watch. You never have any idea what's going on behind those eyes. And that's really fun as well. They're very, very different animals. And it's a lot of fun getting to know them and learning their behaviors throughout all of the years that I've spent with them.
How many years have you spent with them, if you can even remember?
So I've spent since 2017 with Himal. That's when he came here from the Denver Zoo. And then I actually got to know Kira. Kira came in when I was an intern in 2011. So Kira's been here for quite some time. And I left for a couple of years and went to New Orleans and worked at the zoo down there. But then I came back and we fell in love with each other all over again. So I've been working with Kira since 2015.
And if you have any questions, please feel free to type them in the comments section. But I did have a question, another pro tip that we can get from Zookeeper Bridget. If visitors are wanting to visit the zoo and see the snow leopards, you know, have better chances of seeing them a little bit more active, like we're seeing them now, when would be the best times to visit?
Yeah, so it's a good general rule, not just for the snow leopards, but for almost every animal. A lot of our animals, just in life in general, are active at dusk and dawn. So if you go right at the start of open for the zoo at 9 o'clock, or right towards the end of the day when they know they're about to get fed or they know they're about to get something exciting, that's a really good time. You can look in our specific snow leopard exhibit up in the middle right-hand corner. There's like a little cove that tends to be shady that they like to hang out in the summertime. As well as all the way on the top of the exhibit, their favorite spot is to hang out on the rock. Sometimes you'll see just a foot hanging out, maybe a tail hanging down. It's a fun Where's Waldo with the cats, but it's their favorite spot, and it's a classic snow leopard spot, protected on three sides, and only they can get up there.
All right, well, I think we're just about out of time. We're going to let Kira and Himal enjoy their enrichment. Thank you all so much for tuning in for today's Zoo to You. I hope you're able to learn something new about snow leopards, and we look forward to seeing you at the zoo soon.
Thanks, bye! Guys.